Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay. In the last class, okay, we saw the dependence of resistance, right? Resistance depends on length, cross section, material, and the temperature, right? On the four things, the resistance depends. We will talk about the first two today, okay? So we saw resistance is proportional to the length. Resistance is inversely proportional to the area of the cross section. Now, if I combine them, okay, I will get something like this. R is proportional to L by A, correct or not? Okay, if I combine them, I will get R is proportional to L by A. Now, if I want to replace the proportional sign by an equal sign, then what I have to do? I have to introduce a
constant term.
Yes, I have to introduce a constant term. Okay, so let us say the constant term is rho here. You are familiar with rho, right? With rho, we used to express density. Okay, it is that same rho. Okay, now this constant has a special name. That name is specific resistance. Specific resistance. Okay, so the constant name is specific resistance. Now, let us say I want to define the specific resistance, okay? Or I tell you to write the definition of a specific resistance. Then what I can do, what you can do. See, if you take the length as 1 meter, and if you take the area as 1 meter square, okay, both of them 1, 1. Then from that equation, can I write that rho is equal to R? Can I write this one, rho is equal to R? I definitely can write, okay? So rho will be equal to R. So can I define the specific resistance in this way? Kindly notice and listen carefully. Rho Bhaiya wants to admit, okay? Okay. So if I want to, define the specific resistance, I can define it in this way. The specific resistance is the resistance of a specific material. See. A specific resistance is the resistance of a material with 1 meter length and 1 meter square cross sectional area. Okay, like although a specific resistance will be equal to the resistance of a material when we are considering unit length. Unit length means 1 meter, and we are considering unit cross sectional area, that means 1 meter square, right? Unit means one. So please, I will tell you the definition again. I want you to be able to define anything from a given equation, okay? From this equation itself, you can define. So specific resistance will be equal to the resistance of a material with unit length and unit cross-sectional area. Clear?
Sir, any matter?
For any material. For any material. It will be specific for that material, okay? For each
for any density?
The specific resistance will vary, okay? For copper, it will have a certain value. For tungsten, it will have another value. For nickel, it will have another value. Okay?
Okay.
So this specific resistance is for specifically that material. So from here, let us try to write the definition. Okay? So if I try to write the definition, you people will help me. Okay? Tell me what I need to write. Specific resistance. The specific resistance can be defined, as the resistance. Okay, specific resistance is actually a resistance, right? But for this case, it is fixed. The length and area of cross section is specific. It has to be unit, right? That is why it is a specific resistance. Okay, so for a specific resistance, some quantities are specific. Okay, it is fixed. Specific means fixed, right? As the resistance of a material of unit length and unit cross-sectional area. those who joined later, you can see that there is a part on the board which is, you know, being reflected by light. Okay, that is why I'm not writing anything in that box. Okay, I have marked that area. So do not worry, I'm not writing anything there. So this is the definition of a specific resistance. The specific resistance can be defined as the resistance of a material of unit length and unit cross-sectional area. Okay, clear? Now, if I want to find the unit of this specific resistance, then how I can do that? If you notice, R is equal to rho into L by A. Now, if I change the side, I want to find out the unit of rho, right? So I will separate rho in one side. How? A is denominator, so it will be multiplied with the A, right? Cross multiply. And L is numerator, it will come in the denominator here. Correct or not? From here, if I want to find out the unit, okay? What is the unit of resistance?
Ohm.
And what is the unit of area?
Meter square.
Meter square.
Then divided by length is meter, right? So meter will cancel 1 meter from here. So the unit will be ohm meter. Okay. So if you know how to find out the definition and the unit from a single equation, then all you have to keep it in your mind, what is the equation, okay? Not so many things. From here itself, you can find out the definition, you can find out the unit, whatever you want. If you want, you can find out the dimension also. Okay, so kindly find out the dimension and let me know that what is the dimension that you found out. Okay, this is your homework. Okay, so please try to learn these basic things. Okay, this will help you a great deal in the exam. How? Because you know, we are forgetful by nature, we are forgetful, right? In the exam, you will see whenever you are trying to, you know, recall the definition of acceleration, some song will be played in your mind. Okay. You don't want to remember the song, but the song is playing over there. But the definition of acceleration, it is not, you know, coming to your mind. Okay? So our brain is like that. So in this case, if you forget what is the unit of this one for MCQ, you can easily find out in the exam hall itself. Okay? So kindly try to develop this basic. So this is what a specific resistance is. Okay? I can draw the box again. একটু বড় আঁকে ফেলছি মনে হয়। আচ্ছা, so now let us see what are the topic that is next. Specific resistance we already went through. So unit of a specific resistance also done. Okay. Acha, now a similar type of question for 2 mark, okay, that we have seen in the last couple of classes. What do you understand by specific resistance of silver to be silver is actual specific resistance? I will give you that example. 1.6 × 10⁸, 1.6 × 10⁻¹ ohm meter at 20°C. Oh, I forgot to mention one very important point. Please add at constant temperature. Okay, please add this at constant temperature part in the definition of a specific resistance. Okay, because if the temperature is changing, then you cannot say that. Okay, temperature has to be fixed, or else you know that with the change of temperature, the resistance changes, right? So please, please add this one with the in the definition of a specific resistance. Please add this three word at constant temperature. Okay, so here you can see at 20°C. It is this, okay? If I take 30°C, the value will change, right? Okay. So what we understand by this, okay? If I write the answer, it means at 20 degrees Celsius, the resistance of silver of 1 meter length and 1 meter square cross sectional area okay the resistance of silver of 1 meter length and 1 meter square cross sectional area the resistance will be how much the resistance will be this one 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm okay so this will be the resistance of the silver at this temperature for one unit length and unit area okay from the definition itself we can write it okay so similarly I would like to mention some of the important materials specific resistance which is important for MCQ for silver I have already mentioned let us know for copper okay this is the most important one why because in most of the cases copper wire is used as electrical wire okay because it has very low resistance and as a result what is happening the current flowing is good 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter okay the unit will be same then for tungsten it will be a little bit more right for tungsten where it is 5.5 into 10 to the power minus 8
what is tungsten
tungsten is a you know what does it say element copper jet metal element na periodic table theke tungsten is another element okay then nichrome where it has got very high resistance okay acha dekho to nichrome e jehetu high resistance it might seem like or it might you might feel like that there is no use of nichrome but nichrome wire has a you know great use regarding this electricity purpose only can anybody tell me what will be the use what might be the use or where we use it anybody knows creating, about this one
creating fuse
yes that one that might be one but more importantly we use it in heater okay see if a material has high resistance what will happen it will offer more obstacle to the electron right now resistance is caused due to the collision between the atom and molecule of the substance with the electron right as I told you already the collision that takes place between the atom and molecule with the electron okay due to this collision you know what happens Fatima Shahin wants to join okay so due to this collision the resistance is produced right now whenever we are having collision some kind of heat is generated you know right whenever there is you know the friction okay there will be some heat generated so collision also produces some what heat right so whenever there will be a lot of resistance a lot of collision will be there a lot of heat energy will be produced right now can I use if I can use this heat energy then it might be of some use right so similarly actually we put nichrome wire in ketli okay so in ketli we put nichrome wire around it and as a result what happened we connected to the electrical line the current tries to flow through this nichrome wire but a great deal of resistance is offered so as a result what happens a lot of collision up there and a lot of amount of heat is produced using that heat we actually heat our water do you understand so nichrome wire it has a use right so like that any element which offers great resistance if I can you know put it into use to heat any substance that I want then it might be of some purpose right it will serve my purpose do you understand what I tried to mean
yes sir
okay so nichrome wire eta mon rakhba eta sobche beshi use kora hoy ketli tarpor electrical heater je amra bathroom e oi je গরম পানি পাওয়ার জন্য যে হিটার ইউজ করি ওখানেও নাইক্রোম ওয়্যার ইউজ করা হয় সো অ্যাজ এ রেজাল্ট হোয়াট হ্যাপেন্স এ লট অফ হিট ইজ জেনারেটেড এন্ড দ্যাট হিট হিটস আপ আওয়ার ওয়াটার ওকে সো লেট আস মুভ ফরওয়ার্ড এনিবডি হ্যাজ এনি কোশ্চেন টু আস্ক রিগার্ডিং দিস টপিক অফ ইউ নো স্পেসিফিক রেজিস্ট্যান্স
No, sir.
Okay, so we can move forward. The next topic that we have is conductance. Okay, resistance, specific resistance and conductance. Do you think they are similar or opposite to each other?
Opposite to each other.
Opposite to each other. Very good. Conductance means conductivity. Okay. Reciprocal means ulta, and we the symbol through which I express conductance is sigma. Sigma. I hope you are familiar with this symbol, sigma. It is a Greek letter. I guess Greek. I forgot. It is sigma. Okay. Sorry. Conductance is the reciprocal of resistance only. Okay. So resistance er ulta hoche conductance, or specific resistance er ulta hoche conductivity. Okay. So symbol is sigma, and the unit of this one will be as the reciprocal of resistance, that it will be ohm inverse. Okay. Actually, conductance does not have any symbol. Sorry, I made a mistake here. Okay, this is just conductance. Then we will go through conductivity. Conductivity is expressed through sigma. Okay, resistance, the opposite of this one is conductance. Resistance means it will offer obstacle. Conductance means it will, you know, not offer any obstacle. It will not offer obstacle. The electron can pass through easily. So the reciprocal. Okay, the reciprocal of specific resistance. I am writing in short, specific resistance is called conductivity. And conductivity is expressed as, you know, I will write it, I have the symbol. The symbol of this one is sigma. See how I wrote it? Okay, it is sigma. And then the unit of this one I have is ohm meter inverse. Okay, ohm meter inverse. So if I want to write the equation of conductivity, okay, sigma will be equal to one by rho. Okay, the reciprocal of a specific resistance. Now specific resistance is rho. The reciprocal will be 1/rho. Okay. So what is the unit of rho? We know that the unit of rho is ohm meter. So 1/ohm meter, or you can write it ohm meter inverse. Okay, no problem. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us go through a mathematical problem. Okay, always remember, conductance is the opposite of resistance, and conductivity is the opposite of specific resistance. Okay, important for MCQ. Acha, the example that I have, I will read out the question. Listen to me very properly. Okay, the specific resistance of the nichrome wire used in an electric heater. See, nichrome wire is being used where? In electric heater. Okay, so the specific resistance is given, that is rho. It is 100 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. Now, what will be the resistance of 15 meter long wire? I have been asked what is the resistance, and the length is 15 meter. Okay, wire having cross sectional area 2, cross sectional area, that is A, 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter square. Okay, so these are the information given. looking at these quantities, only one equation comes to my mind, that is rho is equal to RA by L. Okay, or else, you know, we can write the first equation that we saw, that is R is equal to rho into L by A. This is the first equation that we got, right? So we have been asked to find out R, so we have separated R. So we can just replace the value, okay, then we will have our answer. 100 into 10 to the power minus 8 into, what is the length? Length is 15 meter. So it will be 15 divided by the area, 2 into 10 to the power minus 7. 2 into 10 to the power minus 7, okay? So I think you are clever enough to solve this on your own, okay? Let me help you. Only 10 to the minus 1 will be there. So 10 inverse 1, 10, 5. The answer should be 75. Can you check in calculator? What is the answer? And as this is resistance, the unit is going to be ohm. Can you check whether the answer is correct or not? Use your calculator and tell me whether the answer is correct or not.
Yes, sir, the answer is correct.
Okay, thank you. So, do you have any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, then we can go forward. How many minutes are left? 11:40. So 10 minutes, around 10 minutes are left, right? Okay, so 10 minutes is enough to discuss our next topic, that is type of connection in a circuit. Okay, type of connection in a circuit. We are going to enter a very interesting topic, okay? I remember Maria saying, sir, apni ekhane interesting ki dekhchen. So, I don't know.
Amar kache interesting lagche.
I will try to make it as interesting as I felt. Okay. I hope you all heard about series connection and parallel connection. Did you go through something like this in grade 8? Series connection?
Yeah, sir.
Yes, sir.
You already have idea then.
Yeah.
The work just became a lot easier. So, series connection. I will draw two circuits and you will tell me which one is series connection and which one is parallel connection. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so let us get started.
This one is series connection.
And the next one is going to be parallel connection, right?
Yes.
Very clear, right? So in series connection, the components are going to be fixed one after another, okay? One after another. And in parallel connection, what will happen? The component will have a common point, right? Common point means, see, this point, if I consider this point, this is common point for both of them. And this is another point that is common for both of them. So there will be two terminal, okay? These are called actually terminal. So two common terminal will be there if the components are in parallel connection, okay? Here, if I take a point in the middle, this is only common, okay? This point and this point, these are not common. Can you say why? Achha, we will...
There is only one switch.
Yes, okay, when we study about common terminal, okay? A jinishta common terminal jinishta ki jodi bhalo moto ekbar bujhte paro, then you will not have any kind of problem, okay? Achha. So clearly this is series connection and this is parallel connection. One major difference between these two type of connection is in series connection only single loop will be there. Yes, only one loop. See, the current has only one path, okay? But here more than one loop will be there, more than one, okay? If the current wants, it will come here. After coming here, it has the option to go through this path and come back here. Or else what it might do, after coming here, it might follow this path, it will come here and it will come back. So there are two loops, right? Understood?
Otherwise it can go to the both of the ways, right?
For the current to, keep imam bujhne.
Otherwise it can go through the both of the ways, right?
Yeah, either of the way. Okay, so there are two loops. Here it has only one path. Here there are two options, two path. At least two path will be there. There might be some more depending on the components. Okay. So this is one major difference between series connection and parallel connection, right? So we will start the next class by discussing about how we can, you know, identify some circuits are very critical. Okay. If there it will be identified that these two resistance are in parallel or series, it will be hard to identify. So if our basic is not clear, okay, depending only on this knowledge, it will not, it is hard to identify the connection in the critical circuits. Okay, so to identify the type of connection in the critical circuit, we must know to identify the common terminal. Now when I can say two point as common terminal, you will see. Okay, next class we will start by discussing about common terminal, inshallah. Okay, so I'm not starting it today, because if I start today, then I won't be able to, you know, finish, because very less amount of time is left. So inshallah, next class I will start. Somebody have written good. Farmida Hussain has written to everyone good. Good what?
Sir, to umama message dise ote bhule shobar kache chole geche good.
উমামা মেসেজ দিছে কোথায় গ্রুপে
এখানে প্রাইভেটলি দিছে আমি ভুলে এভরিওয়ান কে দিয়ে দিছি
ও আচ্ছা
সরি
আমি তোমাকে একটা স্মাইল ব্যাক দিই নাকি থাক দিলাম
না স্যার থাক
ওকে যাক ঠিক আছে তাহলে ওকে সি ইউ ইন দ্য নেক্সট ক্লাস ডু ইউ হ্যাভ এনিথিং টু আস্ক ফ্রম দিস ক্লাস টপিক দেখে বলে দিতে পারবো যে এটার আসলে রেজিস্ট্যান্স কত কালার কোড বলে এটাকে ক্লাসের উপরে আর যদি কোনো কোশ্চেন এখন জিজ্ঞেস করার না থাকে উই উড লাইক টু ফিনিশ ইট হিয়ার টুডে ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ ফর জয়নিং kindly go through you know the topic of series and parallel circuit of your book to gain a little bit of idea so that it is helpful for you to understand whatever I discuss in the next class okay thank you very much for joining assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh
wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh